يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers and sisters, dear viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And I welcome you again in this series of Pioneer Women in Islam. This series that we focus on to reveal to our ummah, to our brothers and sisters, and to everyone about our great history that's full of great women in Islam, that's full of great men in Islam, that's full of great characters in Islam, that's full of great role models in Islam. And we are focusing on women in Islam and Pioneer Women in Islam, whether they are to be wives of prophets, mothers of the believers, whether they are to be warriors or scholars or companions or before the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam or after, for the sake of enhancing and showing people that it's not just about the men in Islam but about the women. And for our sisters to realize that they have a great responsibility towards Islam, and they could do a lot for Islam as these great women did for Islam. And because of them, we are mentioning their name. Because of them, we are learning Islam. Because of them, we have a lot of the ahadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to Islam. Because of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread Islam. And today, inshaAllah, we should be talking about another great woman, another mother of all, a mother of the believers, another wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a wife that was chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like the rest of the wives of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam, for a particular reason. This great mother, this great believing mother, this great wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Safiyah bint Huyay. Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha, she's originally a Jew. She's here from the Yahud. And her father is from amongst the leaders of the Jews. Her father was one of the respected people amongst the Jews, in particular the tribe of Al-Nadir. And she, radiallahu ta'ala anha, she grew up in the household of her father, in the care of her father. She grew up as a Jew. She grew up believing in Judaism. And she was in the care of her father in Bani Nadir, where Bani Nadir used to live next to Medina, next to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam exiled Bani Nadir, the Jewish tribe from Al-Madinah, they went to Al-Khaybar. But at the same time, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam agreed with her father Huyay not to plot against the Muslims. But her father continued to plot against the Muslims. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam executed him with Bani Qurayda, the tribe of Qurayda from the Jews, when they betrayed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and break the treaty and the agreement between them and the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasallam. And previously, before that, she was married to two Jewish men from her tribe, and one of them is her cousin. And once, she says, when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw a scar and a mark on her cheek, the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "What's this from?" So she said, "One day I saw in my dreams that a moon from Yathrib." Yathrib is the name of Medina before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated to it. "A moon from Yathrib appeared and came into my lap. So the next day I told that to my husband. So my husband slapped me so severely that he scarred my face. And he said to her, 'Are you waiting for the king of Yathrib to marry you?' But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted that dream to take place. And that king is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that later on she was the wife of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam." The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the believers captured a lot of the Jewish females during the battle of Khaybar, the great victory of Khaybar, and a lot of them became slaves, and this is the customs back then. Amongst those that were to be captured is Safiyah. Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha was captured, and she was beslaved, and she was taken to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam heard a lot about the beauty of Safiyah and the wisdom of Safiyah. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after he divided the booty, he gave himself Safiyah as his share of that booty. And then he told Safiyah, I offer you Islam and you become a Muslim and become my wife, or I will free you and you could go and follow and chase up with your tribe. So she said, O Messenger of Allah, I'd rather choose Islam over the religion that I never ever used to believe in. That's Judaism. I choose Islam and become your wife. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam accepted that. So he alayhi salatu wasalam made her testify the shahada. She became a Muslim. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam got engaged to her. Then he sallallahu alayhi wasallam got married to her on his way back from Khaybar to Medina sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And she was blessed to be the wife of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Originally a Jew. She's not an Arab. She's a Jew. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam offered Islam to her. She became a Muslim and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam got married to her. And the scholars say there's a hikmah, there's a wisdom from behind why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam got married to Safiyah. This is to show us that there's no discrimination in Islam. She became the mother of the believers even though she's not an Arab. She became the mother of the believers even though that she is not from Quraysh. She became the mother of the believers even though she is a Jew originally. She became the mother of the believers even though her father is one of the severe enemies of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to bring the people of the scripture, the Jews, closer to Islam. That Islam does not discriminate. And Islam does not distinguish between an Arab or non-Arab. It's about your piety and taqwa that makes you better than everyone else. Not just being a Jew. Not just because I'm a Jew, I'm better than others, or because I'm a Muslim, I'm better than others, or because I am an Arab, I'm better than others. It's because of your piety, because of your taqwa, because of your good actions, because of your Islamic actions that makes you better than others. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha to be the wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the other wives of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam used to get jealous from Safiya, as she was known to be good looking, she was a beautiful woman, that some of them amongst each other used to say, looks like this woman, looks like this Safiya is going to take the heart of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam away from us. Safiya radiallahu ta'ala anha, even once she came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam complaining to him about what Aisha and other wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said about her. The wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, we are the cousins of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are the first cousins of the Prophet alaihi salatu wasallam, and we are the daughters of the Arab. In other words, we are closer in lineage to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam than Safiyah. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Safiyah, don't get angry, don't be sad, but tell them, I am better than you because my husband is Muhammad, my father is Harun, and my uncle is Musa alayhi salam. Because she is from the children of Israel. And Harun and Musa are from Bani Israel. And her husband is Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. So the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam said, no, you could be better than them. Say to them next time, I am the wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. I am the daughter of Harun alayhi salam. And I am also the niece of Musa alayhi salam. Muhammad is my husband, Harun is my father, and Musa alayhi salam is my uncle. What an honor. Islam does not discriminate between anyone. You could be the best in the sight of Allah, and you are non-Arab. You could be the best in the sight of Allah, and you have a different color skin than the Arabs. You could be the best in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your tribe or your family is unknown. You could be the best to Allah Azza wa Jalla with your piety and taqwa. Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that the best of you are those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most. And Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha was so loving to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. She loved the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam so much. And who is the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the one that killed her own father. Why? Because she knew the Prophet ﷺ only does something for the right reasons. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, when he does something, he does it for the haq and the truth. And her love to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was greater than her love to her own father and her own family and her own tribe. Why? She saw the true character of this man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. She saw a character of a true prophet. She saw a character of a true, well-mannered man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. Now when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam was on his deathbed, Safiyah said, "O Messenger of Allah, I wish I was in your place than you been in that state that you're in." Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha, she says, "O Messenger of Allah, I wish I am the one in pain. I wish I am the one that's facing the agony of death. I wish I'm the one that's going through this pain, but not you, O Messenger of Allah." This is the love that Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha used to share with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And again, as I mentioned, the other wives of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to get so jealous of Safiyah because of the attention that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to give Safiyah. That once even Aisha became so jealous when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke well of Safiyah, and she said, "O Messenger of Allah, leave her. She's only a short woman. Stop talking about her. You have me. She's only a idha fa innaka qasira." You know, stop talking about her, stop praising her. She's only a short woman. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, "Wallahi, O Aisha, you mentioned a word that if this were to be mixed with the ocean would have mixed with it." That's how bad, the word was that Aisha uttered with, "Leave her, she's only a short woman." Just a word like a short woman. You know how many times we say things about others or make mockery of others, and we think these words mean nothing. Aisha, all Aisha said, "Stop talking about Safiyah, she's a short woman." And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it tells her, "By Allah, you said a word, if that were to be mixed with the oceans, would have mixed with it." Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha experienced the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And later on, Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha continues her journey in Islam after the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she lived during the time of Umar ibn al-Khattab, Abu Bakr and Umar ibn al-Khattab, and she also lived during the time of Uthman and Ali, and she passed away during the time of Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an. And Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha was known to be a righteous woman, a woman that constantly used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She was known with her humbleness, and she was also known with her worship. A woman that used to pray the night and fast during the day. Gives for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That during her time, one of her slaves, one of her she-slaves, went and complained about Safiyah to Umar ibn al-Khattab. And she said to Umar ibn al-Khattab that Safiyah favors Saturday on Friday, and she favors the Jews over the Muslims. Just for no reason, she went and told Umar ibn Khattab that. So Umar ibn Khattab called Safiyah, and he said, "What's this I heard about you, that you favor Saturday over Friday, and you favor the Jews over the Muslims?" She said, "Wallahi, O Umar, I've never favored Saturday over Friday after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me with Islam. I've never favored the Jews over the Muslims after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made me part of this nation." So Umar ibn Khattab believed her. Then Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha asked the slave, the she-slave, "What did you go and do this to me for? What did you go and say that to Umar?" So the slave said, "It was the shaitan." She said, "Shaitan came into my head and made me do that." So Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha did not want to retaliate. She did not want to retaliate and react. But what did she do? She did what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he said, and pardon. Pardon those who harm you. So she pardoned her, and not only she forgave her, but she freed her for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she was a woman that constantly used to advise others and give nasiha and give an advice even to the khulafa, give an advice even to the Muslim khalifs, to the Muslim leaders during her time. She passed away radiallahu ta'ala anha 50 years after the hijrah, and she was old radiallahu ta'ala anha. She passed away and she was buried next to the rest of the mothers of the believers next to the wives of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Baqi', not far away from the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. And she farewelled this dunya radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha, a righteous woman that was known with her righteousness and piety, with her humbleness and understanding, and with her love to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and also the love of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to her. Safiyah radiallahu ta'ala anha, our mother, the wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, a great woman, a great companion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on the soul of Safiyah. Be with us insha'Allah with more great women and more pioneer women in Islam in other episodes. I'll leave you in the care of Allah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وَمَن يَقْنُتْ مِنْكُنَّ لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا نُؤْتِهَا أَجْرَهَا مَرَّتَيْنِ وَأَعْتَدْنَا لَهَا رِزْقًا كَرِيمًا.
وَمَن يَقْنُتْ مِنْكُنَّ لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَتَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
كن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.